Thank you, Chairwoman Leger-Fernandez, and also to Ranking Member Westerman for holding this hearing today. I appreciate the opportunity to provide brief remarks in support of my bill, H.R. 5444, the Truth and Healing Commission on Indian Boarding School Policies Act of 2021. I am a proud member of the Ho-Chunk Nation of Wisconsin. My mom is Crystal Herridge. My grandparents are Ruth Stacy and Lawrence Little George, who are both survivors of boarding schools. And I am honored to be one of the first two Native American women ever elected to Congress. I would not be here today were it not for the resilience of my ancestors and those who came before me. The policies and assimilation practices of the United States had the sole purpose of culturally assimilating American Indian, Alaska Native, and Native Hawaiian children in residential boarding schools across the country. Children were coerced and compelled to attend boarding schools away from their home. Many children did not return to their families or their communities. Those that did return lost generations worth of cultural knowledge, stories, and traditions, and communities lost their language keepers, cultural practitioners, and future leaders. As the co-chair of the Congressional Native American Caucus, I work with other Native members and our colleagues to ensure that the needs of tribal nations and communities are prioritized and that our voices are included in discussions when developing legislation. That's why I worked with Native American Caucus co-chair Tom Cole to introduce H.R. 5444 and to work across the aisle to gather bipartisan support. This legislation will establish a formal commission in the United States to investigate and document the attempted termination of cultures and languages of indigenous peoples and assimilation practices that occurred against Native people through U.S. Indian boarding school policies. This investigation will be documented through culturally respectful and meaningful public hearings, and the commission will receive guidance from a Truth and Healing Advisory Board to develop recommendations for the federal government in a final report due no later than 5 years after enactment. This legislation builds on the important work being done at the Department of Interior. We saw yesterday in volume one of their Federal Boarding School Initiative report that the separation of Native children and families in the name of civilized assimilation caused significant impacts. This bill does not duplicate the efforts of the Department of Interior, but rather expands and continues to acknowledge that legacy with the help of survivors, tribal leaders, policy experts, and communities that can help guide this process. And I'm sure you will learn more from our witnesses today. The impacts of boarding school policies have touched all Native peoples, both past and present. I'd like to acknowledge how painful and uncomfortable these and future conversations are going to be. I honor and thank the witnesses and survivors who are here today, who are brave enough to inform my colleagues about the impacts that boarding school policies have had on their lives and their communities. There were 14 federal Indian boarding schools in Kansas. One sits in the Kansas Third and is the Shawnee Indian Manual Labor School, located in Fairway, Kansas. It's now preserved as the Shawnee Indian Mission State Historic Site, according to the Kansas State Historical Society. It operated from 1838 to 1862, and at one time had nearly 200 children there. And in Lawrence, Kansas, Haskell Indian Industrial Training School was one of the largest early boarding schools in the country. While I was fortunate to attend what is now Haskell Indian Nations University, there still resides a history that must not be forgotten. The campus includes known grave sites of over 100 Native children who died at the school when it was implementing its assimilationist practices. This commission will build off Secretary Holland's Federal Boarding School Initiative by collecting documents and testimony outside the federal boarding school system. The Department of Interior's efforts, along with the bipartisan support of this bill, shows that the branches of federal government are ready to work toward fully acknowledging its contribution to this history. As federal partners, we owe the Native children and lost relatives of the time the resources to investigate and fully understand how we got here. Establishing a Truth and Healing Commission will bring survivors, experts, federal partners, and tribal leaders to the table to continue this investigation and develop a culturally respectful healing process. If Native children were able to endure and survive the Indian boarding school era in our nation, we should be able to find it in ourselves to fully investigate what happened to our relatives and work toward a brighter path for the next seven generations. Thank you again to Chairwoman Leger-Fernandez and Ranking Member Westerman for calling this hearing today, and I'm looking forward to working with the subcommittee and with my colleagues. I yield back.